Okay, ji. So now we will come to the next slide. The next slide is example number 3. And the statement of the example is: determine the following for the fixed bias configuration of figure 4.7. We have to find the IBQ, ICQ, VCEQ, and VB and VC and V base collector. So let us now look at the circuit diagram. The circuit diagram shows one NPN transistor such that the beta is given equal to 50. And the emitter terminal is grounded. Emitter terminal is grounded. So this configuration is common emitter, or this example concerns with common emitter. Then we look at the base terminal. The base terminal has a series resistance called RB equal to 240 kilo ohms, and then it is connected to VCC equal to plus 12 volts. Then let us look at the collector terminal. The collector terminal has a series resistance RC equal to 2.2 kilo ohms, and then the resistance RC is also connected to VCC 12 volts. The gain or the beta is equal to 50. The gain is 50. We have to find IB and ICQ, VCEQ, voltage at the base, voltage at the collector, and voltage base collector. So let us start with the solution. Let us first of all find base current. How can we find the base current? We can find the base current if we draw the root of the base current. That base current will start from VCC. It will flow through RB, and then it will flow through base and then into the emitter. So our base current IB starts from VCC, flows through RB, and then flows into the base, and it exits from the emitter. What is the Kirchhoff voltage law for the base current? The Kirchhoff voltage law for the base current is VCC is equal to IB into RB plus voltage base emitter. Voltage base emitter. We can rearrange this equation for IB such that we get IB is equal to VCC minus VBE over RB. VCC is equal to 12 volt, VBE is equal to 0.7 volt, RB is equal to 240 kilo ohms, and the answer is 47 microampere. So the answer for IB is 47 microampere. So 47 microampere in the base as the base current. Then we can find ICQ. Very simple, that IC is always beta times IB. Beta is 50, IB is 47 microampere. Therefore IC is equal to 2.35 milliampere. this is IC. So we have found IB and we have found IC. Now let us find voltage collector emitter. What is voltage collector emitter? This is the collector terminal and here is the emitter terminal. We have to find VCE. We have to find VCE. First of all, we can apply Kirchhoff voltage law to the collector side such that VCC is equal to voltage VRC plus VCE. This is the KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law applied to the collector side such that VCC is equal to voltage VRC, this is VRC, VRC plus VCE. We can arrange VCC, we can arrange for VCE such that VCE is equal to VCC minus ICRC. IC we have already found and VCE is equal to 6.83 volts. So VCE is equal to 6.83 volts. So we have found VCE. Now let us find VB and VC. This is the, here is the base terminal. We want to find VB. VB is equal to, VBE is equal to 0.7 because emitter is grounded. Emitter is grounded. Emitter is already grounded, therefore VB is equal to 0.7 volt. And since emitter is grounded, then on the same basis, we can write that VC, the collector terminal, is equal to 6. The collector terminal is at a voltage of 6.83 volts. So VB is equal to 0.7 volt and VC is equal to 6.83 volts. And then part number D is voltage base collector. Voltage base collector is very simple. VBC is equal to VB minus VC. We have already found the value of VB and we have already found the value of VC. So we place them in their positions at their locations and find that voltage base collector is equal to minus 6.13 volts. The base collector is equal to minus 6.13 volts. So, ye clear? Any questions so far?
सर अगर हम वेरीफाई करना
चाहें सर ये लास्ट में सा पॉइंट है वीबीसी इसके बारे में थोड़ा सा बता दें
Sir, you're muted.
ठीक है जी देखिए the question is what is VBC? This is the voltage between base collector. So first of all let us look at the emitter. The emitter is grounded. So emitter is at 0 volts. 0 volt. Then there is the base terminal. The base terminal VB is at voltage 0.7 volts because emitter is grounded. Then let us look at collector terminal. VC, collector VC, the voltage of the collector VC is equal to 6.83 volts. Now what we have to find is, we have to find voltage base collector. This is the voltage base collector. VBC, and the formula for VBC is VB minus VC. VB we already know 0.7 volt, VC is equal to 6.83 volt. Therefore, voltage collector base is equal to minus 6.13 volts. ठीक है जी?
Yes sir.
So now let us come to the fourth example. This is our last example.
And sir, what we if we use PNP transistor over here, then what changes we have to make?
The changes will be in terms of the polarity. That is, we will first of all we will change the polarity of VCC. Then the polarity of voltage across RB and RC will also be reversed. ठीक है जी?
यस सर. सर फिर करंट जो ग्राउंड से गुजरेगा वो ग्राउंड से होता हुआ बेस से गुजरेगा?
देखें, वो जो करंट होगा उस सूरत में, अगर आपने इस्तेमाल करना है PNP, तो फिर सिंबल उसका सबसे पहले चेंज करेंगे हम. तो एक करंट फ्लो करेगा फ्रॉम द एमिटर टू द बेस. It is called base current. और हम यहाँ पे minus 12 volt लगा सकते हैं ताकि minus 12 volt से current enter हो. और फिर एक और current flow करेगा into the from the emitter into the collector into RC, and this will be called the current IC. It is now flowing in the opposite direction, whereas the total current flowing in the emitter is still IE. After this, we will also observe that the polarity of RB and polarity of RC are now reversed. ठीक है?